En Cali. A partir del próximo martes de 6 a 7 y 15 de la noche, los 10 de la rumba, porque va a ser algo sensacional, algo espectacular para que goce, para que viva Cali.
Para que la miras, mujer, solo ve el dinero, no ve.
Salsa first arrived in Barranquilla, or more precisely in Colombia, in 1959. It's at this time that we first began listening to Caribbean music. Salsa is a generic title. Before, the different styles were called guaracha, son montuno, huahuanco, and pachanga. Finally, I don't know if it was a Puerto Rican, a Venezuelan, or I might even say a Colombian, who invented the word salsa for all of these Caribbean styles. It is impossible to ignore the fact that Cuba is the mother of these musical styles. It was there that African drums converged together, along with the French flute. And the Cubans, with their genius for music, arranged and adapted them. Salsa, as I said before, concerns all of these different styles which arrived in Colombia in 1959. The steamboats which came from New York, from Houston, Texas, from all of these ports, unloaded their records at Barranquilla, and I was one of the first to begin collecting them.
In Colombia, this already spicy Cuban-style sauce called salsa has been enriched with the country's own traditional music and rhythms, especially those from the tropical region of Chocó on the Pacific coast. Population's black majority has left its mark on the salsa of Cali.
Papá Rovira me contaba ayer que Paco un dinarice se le fue. Paco Rovira me contaba ayer que Paco un dinarice se le fue. Pascual, aquí tenéis tu mujer.
Pascual,
volvámonos a querer.
Pascual,
aquí tenéis tu mujer.
Pascual,
volvámonos a querer. Ahí dice que Pascualito se conformó porque encontró su negra en Opogoro. Que Pascual Rovira dejó de llorar, que con Pacundina se va a casar. Ahí dice que Pascualito se conformó, porque encontró su negra y no cogoró. Que Pascual Rovira dejó de llorar, porque con Pacundina se va a casar.
Quibdó, capital of Chocó, is a boiling pot of salsa where drums beat out life's daily rhythm. Anything can be a pretext to invent new dances, such as this curralao, known by the evocative name of La Caderona, derived from the word cadera, the hips.
Naturally, there are influences. The most obvious are those we find today. Arroyo is music uses drums from the Atlantic coast, but both Nietzsche and Guayacán got their inspiration from the Pacific coast and Chocó, from which they originated. It's a shame that there aren't more musicians willing to free themselves a little from the outside cliched styles of Puerto Rico and New York in order to better dedicate themselves to modern music. There should be a more balanced fusion with world music. Then we would have a richer form of salsa, a super salsa.
Salsa is a dance, a rhythm, and we are ballet dancers. Why not dance salsa with the same language as used in classical dance? This is why we have created this blend in honor of our city of Cali, to bring our own rhythms, our own way of being, to our cultural universe. These are our rhythms, and we believe that throughout its history, ballet has been influenced by both folk and popular dances in every country in which it has developed. This is our music. This is how we work. And in the Barrio Ballet, we have tried to show how this blending occurs, especially between our African and Spanish roots. Notice, for example, how white people dance the contra dance. They dance holding hands, in a line or in a circle. When blacks picked up contra dance, they did it in couples, and from this came la danza. Whites then reorganized the dance, and from la danza was born el danzón and then el son. Our extraordinary crossbreeding was enriched through the permanent relationship between these two origins.
Barrio Ballet. These dancers were all born in the poor barrios which surround every Colombian city. A fertile ground for the blossoming of a thematic salsa whose skillful choreography draws its inspiration from the growing tide of popular dance.
Me abriste tu corazón, Colombia te canto.
more than a simple distraction, salsa is a way of life for more than 50 million Latin Americans. Such a number proves the importance that this social and musical phenomenon has in the Caribbean.
A lulo juice is a big party that someone organizes at their home, and young people go there and dance. They watch and observe the weird dance steps and learn them. This is how new steps are invented. When I have problems, I listen to music. It comforts me and helps me. With music, I can enjoy myself.
What records do you like?
Among the most recent, there's Miserable, and there's another called I Don't Care that I really like. In this situation of conflicts that we live in, that in Colombia is very accentuated and very hard. I think that salsa is above all a social music that illustrates the problems faced by the Latin American. For example, violence and aggression are very frequent themes in salsa, the rejection of institutional values. It was a non-official music, especially at the very beginning. At that time, it had not yet been commercialized and was considered more or less as an underground phenomenon. I see it as a very demanding music, excellent for dancing, very opportunist, and at the end of the day, one in which the bad guy sometimes wins. That's something you never find in other kinds of music or in the movies. It's optimism which animates this Caribbean music. I think that this is the reason why the man in the street has been able to adapt and accept it as his own.
one side of the bridge, the city of Cali. On the other, the suburbs of Juanchito. It is here that every year, for 10 days and nights, an entire people devotes itself to the frenetic cult of salsa.
Son como las flores que vestidas van de mil colores. Ellas nunca entregan sus amores si no están correspondidas. Caminando van por las aceras, contoneando llevan su cintura. Ellas mueven las caderas como los cañaveras.
Salsa is an urban music, and two cities in Colombia constantly compete at their fairs, shows, and carnivals for the title of Salsa Capital. On the Atlantic coast, Barranquilla, and near the Pacific, Cali. Cali Pachanguero has become an anthem that every Colombian knows by heart.
Thank you.
He is known as the musical wizard. Although he sings tonight in Cali, Joe Arroyo, Colombia's greatest salsero, created his style using the drums and Caribbean rhythms of Barranquilla.
Well, as I said, I was fascinated by Cuban music. Someone told me about the arrival of these records in Barranquilla, and I came up with the idea of opening a club to offer this music to my neighbors and then later on to my customers. So I set up business. I was put in contact with the steamboats, as we call them, and they were delighted with me because they brought all these albums and I bought everything they had. Salsa is spontaneous. Anybody can dance it as long as they're able to move their body. My brothers, the people of Cali, have their own very particular way of dancing salsa. But I don't agree with this, because in order to dance salsa, one needs to be very free with his movements.
Yeah.
Barranquilla, the country's principal maritime port, prepares the celebration of its yearly carnival. One of the most colorful in the Caribbean, it is always an impressive musical event where salsa reigns as king. Enormous walls of sound known as pico, perhaps because of the word pickup, are painted with sensuously exotic murals as totems dedicated to the exclusive worship of salsa. More than with women, it is in front of these pico that the salseros of Barranquilla dance. Steamboats have been replaced by freighters, but they continue to dock, loaded with the latest albums of New York salsa. They conjure dreams of travel for the hopeless and dejected who linger along the harbor. Dreams of a new world from where one returns both rich and famous. For them and thousands like them, budding salseros, musicians in the making, the street is the only conservatory.
I think that Colombia could do better in incorporating its cumbia and curulao with salsa rhythms. With all the possibilities that this music offers us today, especially with its brass, its trumpets, trombones, and saxophones, having both jazz and classical harmonies supported by an undeniably original tempo, it could bring about a revival which would continue on to the year 2000.
Mi ninfa, di noche. Aurora.
It's obvious that New York is on the decline. New York has other interests in other kinds of music. But there is a conformism in its sound and in its message that becomes routine. It doesn't have anything new to say. New York salsa has become too white, too superficial and ordinary. Salsa should be rebellious, energetic, sincere, spontaneous. It has lost in the same way as the Michael Jackson craze and has tried to imitate more commercial kinds of music in order to be successful. If in New York it's on the decline, in Colombia it's growing commercially, an active growth which involves the public. But the more enthusiastic fans should demand a greater effort on the part of the musicians to produce more durable and lasting music. For this, you must create more important pieces, as once was the case in New York and still is the case in Cuba. I think it's a great opportunity. Caribbean people will always need something to dance to. The Latino is extremely fond of dance and of dancing. For this, he needs a music which renews itself. It's a big challenge.
Oh,
Colombia, a cantar todos este coro que dice.